News 5 is always investigating, and tonight we want to find out, is the president's immigration crackdown making our communities safer?
It's a good question. The city of Chicago doesn't think so. It's suing the Justice Department for trying to make local law enforcement enforce federal immigration laws. And here in Ohio, the ACLU and Lorain Police Chief are sharing their concerns as well, saying the DOJ overstepped. News 5's James Girardi live right now from the ACLU headquarters in Cleveland with the story all new at 5. And James, Lorain is one of a lot of cities refusing to enforce federal immigration laws.
Danita, that's right, Cleveland as well, and they're being threatened because of it. The Department of Justice threatening to withhold federal funds from police departments that don't comply.
Telling sanctuary cities, as defined by them, that they're not going to fund us for public safety doesn't increase public safety, and it doesn't fix the broken immigration system.
The son of a Puerto Rican immigrant and the Lorain chief of police, Sal Rivera, in 2013 rewrote the city's policing policy to eliminate racial profiling based on immigration.
We don't stop or detain or arrest people based solely on their status.
He spoke to a crowd at the ACLU of Ohio about why Lorain has it right and why his department won't enforce the president's new policies.
You don't decide to stop somebody because they look like they're farm workers and they look like they're undocumented. Yeah.
But that's exactly what the Trump administration is asking city police departments to do, even repealing the priority enforcement program that instructed ICE to target violent criminals. Now, as Rivera says, everyone's fair game.
That was one of the most fearful days of my life because I had my kids in school. I didn't know if I was going to be able to see them again.
A Northeast Ohio Mexican immigrant shared her story as an undocumented woman working and living in fear, not knowing when police or ICE would show up to deport her.
And every time that I was taking my kids to school, if I see a police officer behind me, I would say, duck and don't breathe. Like I was panicking my kids. They were very afraid of police officers.
Rivera says it's that fear he doesn't want preventing his department from doing their best work.
We're not federal law enforcement officers. I didn't join the police department to be an immigration officer. I joined the Lorain Police Department so I can serve the community of Lorain.
And in Lorain, hundreds of thousands of dollars in federal grant money could be at stake if withheld by the Department of Justice. Reporting live in Cleveland for News 5, I'm James Girardi.